For most Americans, a two-bit president was fine as long as the economy stayed strong. During Coolidge's reign, industrial production, corporate profits, and personal income rose to record levels. A new middle class arose from the influx of white-collar job openings. More women were working outside of the home during the 20s. They often held low-paying jobs as typists, office workers, and telephone operators. Sex discrimination kept many women from advancement and promotion. Author Sinclair Lewis wrote, "Women were expected to keep clean and be quick-moving. Beyond that, they were as unimportant to the larger phases of office politics as frogs to a summer hotel." Corporations were experiencing massive growth generated by efficient management, increased productivity, and new technologies. People started investing in the booming stock market for the first time. By mid-decade, more than 1.5 million Americans owned active stock market accounts. A happier workforce and increased wages led to a new era in consumerism. Electricity was becoming prevalent in urban households. With new convenience came must-have items like refrigerators, toasters, irons, vacuum cleaners, and washing machines. Advances in mass production drove down manufacturing costs, which in turn made products cheaper. A Model T car cost $850 in 1908, and by 1927, only set a family back $290. Installment plans were created to make buying high-priced items more affordable. Instead of shelling out $100 for a new washing machine, consumers would put $5 down and pay $8 a month. The dangers of debt and high interest rates didn't enter the minds of most Americans, and shopping raged throughout the decade. Advertising became part of the fabric of American culture as ads dominated newspapers and magazines. Sex appeal, social snobbery, outrageous claims, and fabricated scientific studies convinced consumers to buy more. Retail stores began to sprout up with increasing demand for products. Standard Oil went from 12 gas stations in 1920 to over 1,000 by 1929. The A&P grocery store chain boasted over 15,000 stores nationwide by decade's end. Sears and Roebuck, JCPenney, Woolworth, and many other retailers provided over 160,000 chain stores by the late 20s. Quality of life was on the upswing in America.
Thank you.